Behind the wheel there, you got to stick around for that. But first, it is not just cold out there, it is downright freezing across much of the U.S. Winter is still, believe it or not, 15 days away officially, but today, we're going to have much more on the weather all day today, so stick around for that. But first, we want to tell you about this. Investigators are checking out what role weather may have played. This is weather-related as well. After a small plane smashed into a couple of homes and set them on fire, this happened. Another twist in the mysterious killing of Hollywood publicist Ronnie Chasen. We are learning chilling details in the case of a 14-year-old boy accused of a series of ruthless killings. The teen says he was a hired hitman for a Mexican drug cartel. He faced people remember Don Meredith as the Dallas Cowboys quarterback. Others remember him from Monday Night Football. And some just know Dandy Don because of TV commercials for Lipton iced tea. You may remember that. Big loss.
Love that video. Lots of great memories for a lot of people, Susan, for sure. There's no escaping those who think everything is all about them. You know, I love me some me. We call them narcissists. We work with folks like that. They're in our families. They're everywhere. They fill our newscasts, Susan. That's why we have a newscast sometimes, because of people like that. It has long been considered an illness, but narcissism may be...
Most people can spot narcissistic behavior. If you just look around, you may see it. You see it on reality TV and probably on Facebook. It really is everywhere. But here is the question for you. Is it a mental disorder or just a personality trait? Rochelle Carey is here with what you're saying about it. Hi, Rochelle. What are people saying?
Isn't this a fun topic?
It is.
Okay, well, according to the New York Times, Susan, the group in charge of publishing mental disorders, this manual, says that narcissism is more of a personality trait than an illness. We can all recognize, as you said, the type of behavior. People who have grandiose sense of themselves, they need admiration, and that's not always the worst, but then they often lack empathy for others. Well, all experts do not agree with this move. Some fear that removing it from the list could lessen diagnosis and prevent treatment, because they say that it is still something that needs to be treated. Now we realize with Linda, thanks for calling. So what do you think? Linda says that in her particular situation, she thought that it was a lot more than just a troublesome personality trait, this narcissism. What do you think? What's your experience been? A group of professionals thinks that it is not necessarily a mental disorder, but there is not uniform opinion about this among the experts. What do you think? Narcissism, a personality trait, or something much more serious than that? Call us 1-877-TELL-HLN. You can send us an email, cnn.com/HLN, or tweet us. Go to Twitter, twitter.com/HLNTV, or send me a tweet at Rochelle Carey. Susan, there are certain parts of narcissism that can be good. It can motivate you to want to take pride in yourself, to do well, but then, of course, you can take anything too far.
Yeah,
for sure.
Some people certainly need help, and it's good they're sharing their personal stories, maybe helping others that are watching. All right, Rochelle, thanks. You got to see this one just when you think you've seen it all. You haven't. A teenager is accused of stealing a dump truck and ramming cars with it. Welcome back to HLN News Now. Your Facebook page is getting a I'm going to make him an offer he can't refuse. That famous catchphrase comes from the movie The Godfather. And then First Lady, we're all glammed up for the Kennedy Center Honors last night. Before the big show, the president hosted the honorees at the White House. He got some laughs after stumbling over one word. Take a look. A little guy who's been training for half his life just finished his first marathon. And get this, he's 9. Hayden, people started running long distances when he was just in kindergarten. Salvation Army volunteer was stunned when he saw the donation someone dropped in his kettle. The organization says a woman donated a golden coin worth between $1,300 and $1,500. She also left a note on Friday that she wants to stay anonymous. All she asked in return was to hear the coin was in fact received. Alabama father and the stepmother of his 2 children are under arrest on child abuse charges.